Hey, y'all. Okay, it has been quite a month. It's been really intense. If you're new here, my name's Nicole. My pronouns are she and her, and I live in the Pacific Northwest on what is the traditional territory of the Coast Salish Nations. Today, I am sharing with you my budget reconciliation of March 2020, the month that will go down in history as the longest month of my life. Probably many of you feel very similarly. Okay, so just to start off right off the bat, thankfully, I haven't seen a decrease in income for this month. Because of some hours that got left out of, off of last month's second paycheck, I actually had a slightly higher income this month, but a lower income in February. Thankfully, I haven't seen a layoff. At the moment, I feel pretty stable in my position. I do work for an art studio for a school that is currently not offering studio classes. So I do think that down the line, that could change things, change the stability of my employment. But for right now, I'm feeling very thankful to have a stable income. So as I reconcile, this will not look so different from any other month. You'll see that there are some adjustments I'm making in April for various things. But for now, let's get into this reconciliation. I'm also wondering how you're doing. So let me know down below how this end of month is going for you. I know every single day has been like a wild new adventure, not really in like a good way. But yeah, let me know down below how you're doing and how you're coping. Maybe one way that you're kind of getting through this, I'd love to hear. Okay, let's get into it. As usual, I have changed the planned number to match the received number. This is how much I have left to budget after everything's kind of shaken down. Really quick, I'm going to go through the highlights, the good, the bad, the ugly, and then we'll get into what to do with what's left over. Okay, so I did plan to take in 4,300, and I actually took in 4,524. So that was good. I also wasn't planning on any reimbursements. I did get reimbursements of 107.48. Real quick, I just wanted to share 37.95. That was kind of a regular mileage reimbursement from work. It was from a couple of months ago. I just hadn't picked it up yet. And then about $60 was reimbursed from travel that I had planned actually for this week. I would be in Florida right now if things were going according to plan. I did buy a flight with Alaska Airlines with points, and I had to pay $11.20 in cash. So that was reimbursed, and my points were reimbursed. And actually, honestly, it was so easy to do. I was very pleasantly surprised at how easy it was to cancel that flight. I rented a car, and I think that normally there would not be a reimbursement. But since all travel has been canceled, the company Sixt that I rented through, they gave me a voucher for the majority of the rental, which is, I think was pretty generous of them. I don't know because I've never rented a car and then had to cancel. But I don't think that they needed to do that, so I appreciate it. And then they reimbursed me $58.33 in cash or to my credit card. Okay, moving on. Sharing income was a little over. I had planned to share $150, and I shared closer to $180. 2% for art was a little bit low. I had planned to share 50, 60. Planned to share 60, and I shared only 37. I mean, I spent $37 on art. Everything else is pretty similar until you get to rent. I paid $800. This is, paid in March for April. My rent is usually $550, and I split it with my housemate. But her job was is not a thing anymore, so I went ahead and lowered her rent for the month. That way, it's a little easier for her to handle. It's better for me than paying all of the rent, and we'll see what happens as this month progresses. Otherwise, everything else was super normal. Groceries, unfortunately, this month I did try. I had started the month 75 years ago, March 1st. I had planned to shop the pantry and the freezer and spend as little as possible on groceries. And it didn't really work out that way. I ended up spending a little bit over my budget. So I spent $351.89 instead of $300. I don't think that I went overboard. I just sort of realized that some things needed, like some things that could wait, I felt like I shouldn't wait on just in case. And I probably also spent a little extra money on kind of like convenience or comfort foods than I normally would, also just because of feeling like stressed. So yeah, it was over in that category. What are you gonna do? I mean, I'm gonna keep trying. In restaurants, I planned for 100. I spent $114.65, not too bad. In household, I planned 20 and it was just a couple of dollars over. And I'll say in kiddies, I'd planned 150 and I spent 161. All for kind of the same reason. Going down to gas, I was quite a bit under. I planned 100 and I only spent $37.91, so that I recouped a little bit there. Also in fun, I planned 100 and I spent 49. I think everything else is pretty normal. Okay, so let's get into what's left over. Now, I basically, I'm just going to roll this 86.91 into what is all here. There are a few places that I want to specifically allocate money. And then what I'm going to do with the rest of it, sort of, this is about $1,500 that is allocated down here. What I'm going to do with the rest of it is just allocate it towards my goals that once this all blows over will continue to be my goals. But I'm essentially looking at all of my sinking funds as an extension of my emergency fund. So I have my 3 to 6 month emergency fund that I just saved up. I mean, can we just take a minute to say, like, I've never had an emergency fund, not even $1,000. So having just finished that 3 to 6 month fund feels pretty awesome. But yeah, I'm really thankful that I was able to do that. Anyway, this is basically going to be an extension of that. So I do want to go ahead and allocate $300 toward my tech fund, because right now we're so reliant on technology that I want that money allocated in case something were to go wrong with my laptop or my phone. Upcoming travel actually does not seem like somewhere that I need to put money towards. That's always something I can work on later as things clear up. I am going to put that about $60 that I got back from my reservations that would have been this week in there. So let's go ahead and leave that. You know, it's $289. Let's go ahead and make that a round number. Okay, so that's about $300. I'm going to put $70 there. And then I'm just going to go ahead and drop the rest of it. I'm going to split it between the car fund and the down payment fund. Those are my two sort of more long-term goals. Of course, in case if something happened to my car, it would be a repair, an upkeep, but my long-term goal is replacement. And I'm just going to go ahead and split it between those two things. Again, those are long-term goals, but essentially this is an extension of my emergency fund. Okay, so I'm going to do... Oh, actually, before I do that, I'm going to put $151 back in cats. So that's up to $1,000 because those guys are my favorite beings. And then I'm going to split the rest between car and down payment. So I'm just going to do $250 and $286.75. Oh, wait, that's wrong. $895.21. Okay, so that money is all allocated. I hope that you're doing well. Definitely let me know down below what are some ways that you're coping, and I will see you in the next video.